My contribution will be devoted mostly to intellectual history and also to historiography and also cultural construction of Cossack tradition in Russia. It's very difficult to speak about all Russian, in fact, very different tradition of Cossackdom during the last two centuries, but I try and put maybe more attention not to that element that Aleksandr Osipyan yesterday pointed. Aleksandr treated Russian tradition of Cossackdom mostly as far right, conservative, fundamentalist, orthodox way, and based on the reality of last 20 or 30 years. But I try to show that in historical reality, the tradition or in plural traditions of Cossacks, of Cossackdom in Russia, mostly on Don and Kuban, was much more complicated in that single and also constructed picture. So maybe Cossack myth for the Russia, it's mostly the myth of Cossack revival. So in intellectual tradition from Enlightenment or Romanticism to years of Russian-Ukrainian Revolution, we have to deal with much more complicated and multi-dimensional picture of Russian Cossack ideas and tradition. And in Western historiography, main attention also put the social or maybe cultural ideas, partly ethnographical, traits of Cossacks in Caucasus, in Far East, Siberia, Central Asia, and so on, but not to the intellectual and historiographical dimension of what is Cossacks represented themselves and so on from American military and also diplomat William Penn Cresson, who describes the Cossacks just mostly Russian Don Cossacks justly from the period that Artyom spoke before me. And to the new works of Shonarurke, we have also, and in good but brief Andreas Kapeler book on Cossacks, they described mostly social history of Cossackdom, and I put more or based on recent historiographical tradition, the rise of Cossack romantic historiography, and usually, especially military men, as Vasily Sukhorukov, friend of Alexander Pushkin, and Pushkin mentioned him in a trip to Ars Room, try to put first romantic picture of the rise of Cossack tradition from the uprising of the 17th century. But it was not only, as in case of Sukhorukov, scholar, maybe semi-academic tradition. Sukhorukov was the author of and editor of Almanach Russian Ancients, Ruskaya Starina, during the 20 years of the 19th century, but also some kind of folk history tradition, historical vision of ordinary Cossacks and laymen, as, for example, Ivan Pikatelnikov, religious dissident and low rank officer of Cossackdom during the time of Alexander the First. And this romantic vision of Cossackdom, in fact, from Sukhrukov or maybe for German engineer Alexander Riegelmann, also overlapped with statistical vision of settlements of Cossacks, Stanitsa and his military service. So this military and statistical dimension very often blurred with historical vision of how is Cossack colonization of Don Caucasus and Siberia was happened in the past. And besides this descriptive vision of Cossackdom mostly on Don or Kuban materials, it was special thinking of Russian from above, from the capitals, from Moscow, vision or from London, vision of Alexander Yeltsin in Christdom Property essay before the Great Reform. Gertsen pictures Cossacks as a special kind of Russian Normans and try to describe Cossacks as free people, and maybe the main ideas of my contribution is the change of the vision from Cossacks as representative of this free will people movement from below to the image that Aleksandr Sitkyan put as fundamentalist guards of unity state tradition and pillars of empire. And these ideas of Gertsen, semi-philosophical, semi-romantic, was also survived even in Nikolai Kostomarov, historian, vision of evolution of Zaporozhian host and also Don and another tradition. During the Great Reforms, it was a lot of debate between Ivan Krasnov, one of the big Krasnov family, and I also mentioned this family name once more, because the admirer of old Cossack social tradition against to to vision of Cossacks as one estate in big society, element of new modern development, not only some military remnants of glorious Russian past. And really in level of political division, Cossack troops exist really in level geographical divisions, but mostly from Don and Kuban was the most troops in irregular army corps. And from the times of Vasily Sukhrukov, Don Statistical Committee was really the one academic institution for the describing and for the reconstructed of not only recent situation from point of view military statistics and conscription, but also from historical point of view. And some of works of Sukhorukov, Branevsky, and other people was re-edited from the private archives 30 or 40 years after, not in 1830, but in 1860, when the after the Great Reform, when the Statistical Committee was really a big intellectual enterprise. So this overlapping of military, civil, and statistical tradition was also relevant for historical vision of Cossack's past, for example, in person of Hariton Popov, who was the member of Statistical Committee, but also military man and founder of museum devoted to history of Don's Cossack, and this kind of blurring statistic and ethnography was also typical for this kind of post-romantic positivist vision, and the maybe main figure for this stream was Fyodor Scherbina, who devoted to People's Socialist Party and close to also populist movement from Moscow, Odessa, and his native Don Novoderyavyankovskaya Stanitsa. And Scherbina was the author of the contribution to Kuban's history from the Voronezh, because most part of this period in the end of 19th century he was spent in Voronezh Zemstvo. He was a correspondent member of Imperial Academy of Science, but his main historical works about the Kuban past was published in 1910-1913 in two volumes. And his history of Kuban region was different from previous semi-romantic, semi-statistical positivist vision, because Scherbina put main attention, as Grushevsky, for example, for Ukrainian historiography, to social stratification. As populist, he tried to rediscover history of below, history of ordinary Cossacks against Starshina, against Cossacks noblemen. So not all representative or admirer old-fashioned Cossack historiography was received very positive Scherbina work, and he had some criticism, but posthumously in the turn of 20th and 21st century, Scherbina was glorified in Krasnodar as founder of historiography. His works and his autobiography re-edited, and Aleksandr Polyanichev defended his very interesting and rich by material PhD thesis in Florence European University Institute about, especially Scherbina was one of his hero of this process of reenactment of not only region tradition, but also Ukrainian tradition of Cossackdom. But Scherbina populist trend was not the single. It was also very influenced rightist, but not far right. Not only Black Hundred was popular in Don, for example, progressivists, Octobrists, more moderate but monarchy oriented movements also were displayed in especially Don region, and Boris Korniyenko in his very interesting book about rightist Don describe this picture of first Cossack Renaissance of the second century, also with historical dimension. And if Peter Sakharov continues the Scherbina scientific line, much more popular for this non-populist vision of Cossack's past was ideas of Yevgraf Savelyev, who was popular not only in that period, but also after the perestroika, and Savelyev now one of the main author for Redditor, the idea of glorious ancient roots of Cossacks, and his Savelyev's idea of 1,000 years of Cossack history is very, very close to a kind of recent folk history by, I don't know, Mikhail Zadornov and so on, about the Etruscan or ancient, comparative to ancient Greeks, history of Cossackdom with obvious opposition to Western tradition of past and also history from below, but in very obscure post-romantic way. Yeah, also we have not only Mesoamerican, but we have Crete, Troya, Etruscia, and so on. Yes, it is not. It's very typical narrative of post-Soviet folk historiography, but really its roots also they were in 1918, and this vision was mobilized not Scherbina, but Savelyev kind of historical vision was mobilized during the turbulent years of the Civil War, when the idea of Don's and Kuban autonomies, or maybe federalist vision, have the political embodiment during the Civil War in Kornilov and then Krasnov movement from so-called white side, and Scherbina was also the member of these groups, but leftists was not prevalent, but have some obvious influence in the this history of civil war development of Don and Kuban autonomy, and after the perestroika, this moment of Don development between white and red side of civil war confrontation was also popular and have his attention in history of Don. Ideas from Sholokhov and his hero, it's mainly reason to remember Bakhtin division of author and hero and Grigory Melikhov. It's I don't know who these ideas of Don autonomy or Don against Moscow, Don against Russia is also popular among the rightist Don writer that Boris Korniyenko described, but what this voice is belonging to Sholokhov or to Melikhov or to some another author, because the figure of Sholokhov was very complicated, as supposed, it seems, not a single author of this epos novel, and because from the very beginning of publication of novel in the late 20s, it was a lot of there were a lot of debates about the real author or collective of author of this vision of dawn, because real Mikhail Sholokhov in 20s was too young for distributed this complicated and not read vision of recent past of civil war and the Great War, Cossack involvement of Russian military campaign. But the figure of Sholokhov is also in immigration, and now, after the Nobel Prize, the figure of hot debate between admirer and people who relate Sholokhov as a single author of this novel, but in Kubanin Don tradition, prevalent in Russia also, the vision Sholokhov as a single author with his red and very Communist Party conservative line vision from after Second World War deeds and his confrontation with Sinyavsky and Danielian dissident movement is also obvious. But in Exiled we have some kind of continuation of Scherbina's line, and yesterday we think and debated Dragomanov left liberal line of how it's survived or exist in not only in Ukrainian but also in Russian tradition. And this federalist vision of Cossackdom was not only Ukrainian privilege but also typical for Sibiri idea of oblastnichestvo by Yedrintsev, Potanin and Sergei Svatikov, journalist and Mensheviks in exiled time during the 20s was close to circles of Don Historical Commission, who tried to follow in the line of Don Statistical Committee to describe of more social history of Cossackdom and complicated relation between Big Russia and Don with federalist vision. And the Savelyev line, or more rightist line, similar to Krasnov, who was also very active in Cossack military emigre circle during the 20s and the 30s. It was also Free Cossack movement that published some historical almanac and political almanac and also historical literature, for example, almanac of devoted to the past of Don and Kuban as autonomist from Russian state centralized grand narrative, and also General Isaac Bekadorov was an opponent of Petr Krasnov and more conservative monarchist majority in the Russian exiled, and this movement was also active in the Second World War with collaboration engagement of Petr Krasnov. But I put much more attention to the process of Cossack Renaissance during Perestroika and post-communist time, and also put the history to especially maybe some attention to Jewish vision, because, for example, first biographer of Sholokhov during the 30 and the 40 years was a Jew, Isai Lezhnev from Pravda, or Vinyamin Goffenscheffer. It's interesting and contrasted with usual vision of Cossack anti-Semitism and personal Sholokhov anti-Semitism, but also some Jewish historian as Aleksandr Pronstein put even in late Soviet period gave a lot for the ideas of reconstruction of Cossack pasts as social movements to Budavin or to Razin Cossack or peasant uprising, but after 1991, much more useful for a new grand narrative was ideas even Peter Krasnov, despite of his collaboration with Nazis. Yes, he was collaborator, but his vision of Don and his popular work, not far from Yevgraf Saveliev, Etruscan vision of Cossack's roots, was popular in post-Soviet situation, and it was special kind of regional history. Yeah? It's a textbook for cadet schools, military, paramilitary schools for young men in Russia, and also with Sevastopol vision. I suppose it was published after 2014, but really we have textbook about history of Kuban Cossackdom from first class to 10 and 11. Yeah, we have all line in every degree of education in these regions. We have special books similar to textbook about history of Ukrainian SSR parallel to Grand Soviet Union narrative, very similar to Brezhnev situation of Republican narrative within Soviet Union narrative. And maybe my last point, that in big flaws of Cossack's historiography of the 21st century, we have not only the distance from any Ukrainian past, for example, Scherbina was reburied, remains of Scherbina was reburied from Prague to Krasnodar with monument, but maybe no one words about his Ukrainian activity, and only in Wikipedia we have small mentions that in really, Scherbina in the 20 years was a professor of Podebrat Academy or Ukrainian University and published mostly on Ukrainian, but he was our great historian of our Kuban past, and this revision of real figure of Scherbina was also very typical, and despite of this state-oriented vision of Russian Cossackdom, we have some deeds of enthusiasts, as for example Viktor Chumachenko, who put more attention to idea of connection between, as Alexander Polyanichev and others, attention to real contact between Ukrainian and regional Kubanian Don activists, historian and social movements during the first half of the second century. So it's not only a single Cossack tradition in toto, but a very different kind if we can show this condition from point of intellectual history now. Yes. Thank you. Sorry for a lot of time.